I would say he's a very easygoing guy and relaxed guy off the field. And then he puts a rugby jersey on and he totally transforms into something totally different. This absolute beast. He doesn't hold back. He just goes 100%, 100% of the time. Will definitely go down as one of the greats of South African rugby.
An incredible piece of physical ability. He's just caught man and ball.
In early 2013, he got a pain in his calf, which they found out was caused by an arachnoid cyst in his lower spine.
The first operation he went for, he picked up the hospital bug. After that, it was just like a snowball from bad to worse. So we waited for his results, and he had meningitis, and then it was a matter of is he going to make it or not with the right treatment.
Heavy doses of antibiotics, cortisone, assisted breathing.
They're pumping him full of drugs. They might not even work and might actually even kill him.
And he was in a coma, literally. So it can go either way. There's a 50% chance of dying, probably.
I mean, he couldn't open his eyes. He could hardly talk. They were down and out. His temperature was so high. The bed was covered in sweat, you know, like proper infection.
The first thing I saw was Schalk, his dad, and had a small little white cloth in his hand that he was just rubbing Skalk's neck and forehead. And as he was wiping it, the tears were just coming down his face.
And it brings back the same emotion that standing there, he really thought, this is it. Now, do you say goodbye? Or don't you say goodbye? I'm not a guy who can say goodbye. I'm like willing him on, please just get through this.
It was really a difficult time for us as a family. You know, you just go from minute to minute, really.
Just to have his mouth, he was all we wanted.
Well, you can hear the crowd building to a crescendo. You consider where he was, not only in his career, but on a hospital bed, and straight into the thick of the action.
Schalk Burger, he is back. I want to be here, I want to win rugby matches, and I want to do my bit.
I wasn't ready to say goodbye, so, you know, for a bit of luck, and I think for a bit of stubbornness, I was able to pull through.
Burger, a veteran of 75 test matches, and a nominee for the Laureus Sports Award. That's Schalk Burger, beautiful loop around from him. Burger! Just a couple of...
They thought he'll never play sport again.
I said his rugby career was over.
A wonderful ambassador for South African rugby and for the game itself.
They had to do four more operations. They had to lie flat on his back for about 40 days or something like that.
He has come back so often from career-threatening injuries, from life-threatening injuries.
He lost 16 kilograms in weight and they had to start all over again.
He had to teach himself to walk, teach himself to run.
His 100th Super Rugby match for his beloved Stormers.
To get through that and then play international rugby after that, those are the one percenters in the world that can do that.
I think most other people would have called it quits. You know, I think his spirit has just carried it.
And Berger, devastating counter-attack.
I didn't get much opportunity to play, and I'm proud that the country is giving him that opportunity. I think that's what's more important.
I'm just proud of his comeback, but also what an incredible father he is. Family time is everything for him now after that. He's just so grateful to be alive and to live life. The rugby is just a bonus. It's a cherry on top.
Pick up by Scottberg and try! Two decorated spin box working in concert.
If I think back, I can't believe where I've come from to play for the Springboks again.
You know, there's a World Cup coming up. Been fortunate enough to be involved in quite a few, and I really want to be involved in this one. So, you know, hopefully it can happen for me. That's how a superhero learns to.